We're looking at how crime was going before, looking at some of the period just before these orders were implemented, and then I call for at least two periods to look at crime during the actual stay-at-home orders. And I think that's because depending on how long these orders were implemented, you're going to have people who respond in different ways. So as you're familiar with, some states and communities had stay-at-home orders for only a few weeks or a month. Others had it for several months. And it's very likely that people who are told to stay at home for a long period of time will eventually begin to get out a little bit more. And in fact, we have seen some data that shows that that's very true. But this effect changes over time. And so I think it's important to look at data both at the beginning of a stay-at-home order and the end of it.